Brian, there's your challenge. So Brian is the chief executive of Black Rhino, relative newcomer, or it probably doesn't feel like that. So Brian, take it away.
Great. Thank you very much. Yeah, so I'm CEO of Black Rhino, which is one of Blackstone's investment platforms. Blackstone's approach to global power is getting behind regional platforms that will deploy capital from the fund. So today there's 10 different platforms focused across the globe, with Black Rhino being focused on Africa. My previous experience, I've been a greenfield developer in Africa for 20 years now. And previously I'd founded the Seacom Cable before coming back to the power space. Right now we're involved in a project in Nigeria, approximately 570 megawatt gas-fired power plant. And it's a very interesting for me when we think about case studies. You know, it's an incredibly interesting space to be in, and sometimes frustrating. Nigeria, to me, when I think some of the lessons when I talk about countries that we approach, is I've moved more and more to pay attention to IMF macro views of countries over a period of time. At the end of the day, these are very long relationships that you're going to create with these different governments, and the workings of, not just from a development perspective, but also an operations and a payment perspective, will ebb and flow with the success of the country. So in our predecessor, working in Uganda on the Bujagali Hydro, they went from hero in bringing power into the country to villain in having too expensive of a PPA. And it's very important to be tied into that. I think if you look at Egypt, Egypt's become a fascinating place for everyone to invest in. You know, they've followed the rules of the IMF, they've followed the rules of currency, et cetera. And being in Nigeria at least once a month, you're seeing a lot of that start to take place now with the cooperation with the World Bank today, starting to float the currency. It creates a energy and a view of moving forward. So I think at a macro level, we've taken our company to follow the success countries maybe more than I did historically. And that requires quite a discipline, because you can get attracted to a project and sometimes you have to say to yourself, well, it might be a nice project, but not a nice investment climate. So that's at a macro side. At a development side, I think we've changed our approach as well, and we've become much more collaborative. So sitting with Vishal, you know, we're working with GE as a co-developer in Nigeria. You know, it's incredibly important. You know, for us, being owned by Blackstone, we have access to a huge amount of funds, but they're not close to Africa, and they don't see the day-to-day patience that's required and understanding everything that's needed. I tell them on weekly calls, you know, why something didn't happen this week, and just be patient. But to be able to go to a partner like GE and to be able to explain at that level why, as partners, we understand something will be successful, but it takes enough time, you know, or to have partnerships with other big names, it creates a lot of comfort to be sitting there together, even if you feel like you don't need access to the capital itself. It's that partnership, it's the ability to push things from different angles that's become very important to us. And then I think on the lessons of working in the project finance space, I think if you look at Seacom, we were able to build that on a very merchant basis. There were hundreds, if not thousands, of customers that you could target. But when you build a power plant, at the end of the day, it becomes a stranded asset if your customer isn't there anymore. And these are just too big of investments to take that sort of risk. So for us today, it is still very much a project finance world, although I would like to see that evolve and change. But getting those risks right around how do you ensure you don't end up with a stranded asset is probably 99% of the arguments. You know, the commercial side of this can get done fairly quickly. It's really the T's and C's around making sure it's not a stranded asset. This has been a very difficult lesson, because with the DFIs and the government involved, and Nigeria has been an incredible case study, bringing communication together has been very important. You know, we've found if everyone's sitting in a room, you can get a lot more done faster than when the developer is playing telephone between the two sides. But that's tough to do. It's tough to get everyone in a room together and have the conversation together. And I think that's what we've been spending a lot more of our time on, how to play broker in getting those collaborating sides together, because the sides may be closer than they actually think they are together. You know, and that's probably the greatest lesson that I'm in the action of learning right now. I haven't learned it yet, but working on. Thank you.
That's a great one, Brian. Thanks very much. And I mean, something very much worthwhile bearing in mind. Certainly, I hear it from IFC.
Doing business in Africa. You can't afford to be without Africa Investor.